रविश्चंद्रो घना वृक्षाः नदी गावश्च सज्जनाः एते परोपकाराय युगे देवेन निर्मिताः।
As per the age-old traditions of Bharatiya Sanskriti, the life of an individual revolves around the virtues of love and sacrifice. Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam is our broad idea encompassing all the living beings and non-living objects on the Mother Earth. In the small state of Goa, a seal of social service was sown with the inspiration and support from Vishwa Hindu Parishad. This was the birth of Matruchhaya Trust. Matruchhaya is mother's home. Activities of Matruchhaya Trust have spread in all corners of Goa in the last 35 years.
In the year 1976, Matruchhaya was established as a home for orphans and destitute children. It then set up Balakalyan Ashram for boys. With the aim of inculcating Bharatiya Sanskaras in children, Matruchhaya started Sanskar Kendras and nurseries in different parts of Goa. In the area of healthcare, Matruchhaya runs a patient's aid cell at GMC Hospital, Bambolim, Rugnashray, a short stay home for patients at Kalapur, medical service centers in remote areas of Goa, ambulance service, permanent Jaipur Foot Center at Kalapur, home nursing units in North and South Goa, Suvarna Prashan camps and medical camps. A day in Matruchhaya begins with the children getting up at around 5:30 in the morning. Simultaneously, it's Ratna Maushi lighting the lamp before Lord Ganesha and praying for a peaceful, enriching day. As the morning tea comes to a boil, the girls are getting ready. Breakfast preparations are going on in the kitchen. It's time for morning yogasanas and warm-up. Once the girls are off to school, activities gear up in the baby's room. Babies are given oil massage and hot water bath. It's time now to feed them with infant formula and rock the cradles to pacify them. Let's peep into the toddler's room. In the atmosphere of love and affection, they are brought up in a playful manner. The little ones are turning the pages of colorful books to see pictures, letters, numbers, and words. Day-to-day administrative activities start in the office located on the ground floor. Ladies in the kitchen are busy cutting, chopping, peeling, kneading dough, stirring and cooking. The preparations are on for the lunch. By this time, girls from the school come back home happily and eagerly. Every day, a different group of girls helps in kitchen and serves the food. Praying to God before meals is a custom to express our gratitude. Kaka, kaku and guests, all are having food with the children sitting on the floor in a traditional manner. After siesta, a different set of activities starts. Girls from 8th to 12th standard go to library come study room. In another hall, coaching for the girls of 5th, 6th and 7th standard is going on with special attention by the tutor. In this room, primary school girls are completing their homework under the guidance of teachers. some girls are displaying their creativity on computer screens in computer room. It's time now to play, from the age-old simple games to swings and seesaws. After the refreshing play, it's time for evening snacks. Every evening, a traditional lamp is lit at Tulsi Vrindavan. This is an evening prayer session. It includes Shubham Karoti, tables, shlokas, bhajans, aarti and pasayadan. It's a recreation time for girls till dinner is served. Little ones are tired and hungry. After the dinner, it's bedtime. Matru Chhaya was established on 14th November 1976 on Children's Day.
There are mothers, because of their difficulty, they leave the child. For example, Devaki Mata also left the child. She was in difficulty. The role of Yashoda Mata is to be played by some institution. So that was the feeling, and with that feeling, to give Yashoda Mata's chhaya to all the orphan and destitute children, Matru Chhaya concept was materialized.
It started with just one orphan found at Savade railway station, which was embraced by Srimati Savita Tai Ramnathkar. Many well-wishers offered their premises for Matru Chhaya. The number of orphans went on increasing. Matru Chhaya moved to its own building, Shanta Durga Prasad, constructed on the land donated by Sri Shanta Durga Devasthan Samiti in 1982. From the initial 20 children, it now looks after around 75 children. The founder chairman of Matru Chhaya Trust was Sri V.M. Salgaonkar. Then, Sri Vasudev Rao Dempo took over. The present chairman is Sri Mohan Das Naik. When the cry of the baby is heard from the cradle hanging outside the gate of Matru Chhaya, it's a very emotional moment. The cute little baby, relinquished by someone and left to feel insecure, is embraced by Matru Chhaya. After traditional limbalona, complete medical examination of the baby is done. Premature or weak babies are admitted to neonatal care unit till they become fit. Naming ceremony of the newcomer is celebrated in a joyous atmosphere. All the customary rituals are performed. Matru Chhaya finds suitable prospective parents for the child. Till today, more than 300 children of Matru Chhaya have been given in adoption. In addition to orphans, the destitute children are also embraced by Matru Chhaya. The trustees, committee members, superintendent, staff and volunteers focus on developing family bondings. Children refer to them as Kaka, Kaku, Dilip Mama, Ratna Maushi, Sarita Didi, Sunil Dada, Nimatai, Kalinditai, Aji and so on. Matru Chhaya indeed is one big family. Bharatiya Samskaras, Sanskriti and values are inculcated in children. Elder ones help the younger ones with love and care. Religious festivals and rituals are celebrated with great enthusiasm and zeal. Children are taken to different picnic spots in Goa occasionally. Various social groups, clubs, educational institutions and kind-hearted individuals visit Matru Chhaya to interact with children and conduct various activities for them. Girls participate in various cultural programs, competitions, and sports events at state and national level. Matru Chhaya feels proud to display the trophies, medals, and certificates of merit bagged by her sons and daughters. After completion of schooling, they are sent for vocational training, technical courses, nursing courses, or professional colleges as per their potential and aptitude. After that, they are encouraged to take up jobs or set up small businesses. When they come to a marriageable age, Matru Chhaya family finds a suitable life partner for each of them. Till today, 15 daughters and one son of Matru Chhaya have got married. Matru Chhaya is proud to have so many grandchildren. Spiritual and religious leaders, Governor of Goa, eminent personalities from the fields like literature, music, art, business and corporate world have visited Matru Chhaya and blessed the children. In 1983, the superintendent of Matru Chhaya, Ms. Vijaya Bhange, received Mitra Beer Award for social work. In 1988, another superintendent, Srimati Alkatai Parulekar, received National Award for Best Social Worker in the hands of President of India. Matru Chhaya received the State Award for Best Social Service Project in the year 1988. The title of Best Mother was conferred to Matru Chhaya by Pune Marathi Granthalay. In the year 2001, Matru Chhaya celebrated its Silver Jubilee year by setting up Seva 25 project under the leadership of Sri Shivanand Salgaonkar. Altogether, 25 new projects were started. Matru Chhaya Medical Service Center started in 14 villages in remote parts of Goa. Many specialist doctors offer their valuable services for Matru Chhaya medical centers once in a week. Consultancy and medicines are provided free of cost to the villagers. Local people have come forward offering their premises and help. Companies like Seza Goa and VM Salgaonkar and Brothers Private Limited provide financial assistance to some centers, which also include a mobile health unit. Some of these centers have become a permanent feature now. Suvarna Prashan Kendras. In these centers, children up to the age of 5 years are given a dose of Suvarna Prash, that is gold linctus, on Pushya Nakshatra every month. It builds immunity and boosts intellect as well as proper development.
This is the daily hustle bustle at Goa Medical College Hospital at Bambolim. Amongst the noisy crowds, ambulances, vehicles, horns, stretchers, wheelchairs, casualties, patients, doctors, nurses and ward boys, there is one small room in GMC where 28 young volunteers are chanting Ekatmata Mantra.
These are the dedicated young volunteers of the Patients Aid Cell started in the year 2001. Mineral Foundation of Goa gives monetary assistance to this project. The 28 volunteers help about 800 people every day. They help the patients in making case papers, registration, arranging blood, assisting for x-rays and scans, assisting the casualties, helping people with language problem, helping the deaf, dumb and blind.
मातृच्छाया ही संस्था आज मेडिकलांनी येऊन जवळजवळ 10 वर्षांस पूर्ण झाली आसा. आजपर्यंत आम्ही जो वावर केलेलो आसा तो खूप लक्षणीय जावन आसा.
द वर्कर्स हू आर देन आर रियली पोलाइट एंड कंटेजियस एंड दे रियली असिस्ट द पेशंट एज पर देयर रिक्वायरमेंट.
एम्ब्युलन्स सर्विस. Matru Chhaya Seva 25 project also provides an ambulance service at subsidized rate. But the service is free for poor and needy patients. Rungnashray. Volunteers of Patients Aid Cell realize that some patients need to visit GMC Hospital again and again for tests, reports, treatments and follow-ups. These patients and their relatives face a great problem of temporary stay. Rungnashray was conceptualized to cater to their needs. It started functioning in the year 2007. Located at Kalapur, this short-stay home for patients and their relatives is at a 10-minute walk from the GMC hospital. This is a three-storied building constructed on the slope of a hill. Rungnashray provides lodging, boarding and healthcare assistance to the patients. It has well-equipped rooms and canteen for patients and their relatives. This is the front office with the dedicated staff and volunteers. It also has a meditation and yoga room. The huge lobbies in Rungnashray are created with the aim of crisis management. During crisis, even about 200 patients could be treated here with the help of local doctors. Let's visit the Physiotherapy and Rehabilitation Center. Rungnashray provides a unique facility wherein the patients can stay and have the physiotherapy. Cancer patients and orthopedic patients stay here for a prolonged period during their treatment and follow-ups at GMC Hospital. Delivery patients and other patients, along with their relatives, find it convenient to stay here after they are discharged from the GMC Hospital. The services at Rungnashray are available at very reasonable rates. For the poor and needy, the services are offered free of cost. Rungnashray regularly conducts free medical camps by specialist doctors, which have helped thousands of patients till today. Dedicated committee members, staff and volunteers of Rungnashray are carrying ahead the torch of Seva Karyas. Completion of 35 years was a milestone to look back and plan for the future. Matru Chhaya named it as Sankalp 35. Instead of grand celebrations and parties, Sankalp 35 aimed at expansion and promotion of Seva Karyas and launched an awareness drive called Sampark Abhiyan.
These were the projects planned under Sankalp 35.
Jaipur Food Center. On 26 November 2011, a permanent center for artificial limbs, popularly known as Jaipur Food, was started in the basement of Rungnashray building at Kalapur. Earlier, people of Goa had to wait for months together as the limbs were manufactured outside Goa. Now, this center manufactures the artificial limbs and gives them to patient in a short period of time. Home nursing courses. Sensing the increasing need of home nurses, Matru Chhaya decided to train the youth in remote areas of Goa for home nursing. The courses have been started at Torshe Pedne in North Goa and Kankon in South Goa.
Matru Chhaya Bal Kalyan Ashram.
Talavlikar brothers from Panji donated their ancestral house and surrounding land in Talavlim to Matru Chhaya, and the need of a separate dwelling for boys was fulfilled. This house, located at a distance of 3 kilometers from Matru Chhaya, started functioning as Bal Kalyan Ashram for boys in June 2010. Presently, 16 boys are staying in this homely abode. They go to local schools. The daily activities are woven in and around this beautiful ancestral house. A variety of indoor games, self-study, special tuitions, everything happens under one roof. Matru Chhaya has purchased the adjacent land to construct a new well-equipped building. This is a perspective view of the proposed building of Matruchhaya Balakalyan Ashram. This will cater to the needs of more than 50 boys. As boys have shown great interest and talent in sports, a playground and other facilities will be taken care of in this project. Kabaddi, football and cricket are the most popular games over here.